Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we're going to do TTrockstars again. Number 5 it is. And in the light of what we've just heard from Jacob and Small, what the next week brings us. Your take first. So, clearly the Green Speech is still underway. Jacob Rees-Mogg has said he'd like to have another meaningful vote on Monday, but I think there's a big question about whether the Speaker will allow the government to do that. The House has just been asked for another meaningful vote. We've all learned very clearly this parliamentary rule that you can't ask the House the same question twice in one session. The Speaker's gone off to take advice on whether he's going to allow that.
What I want you to do is to, for those who are joining us,
really irritates me. At least you know where you are with your Samsung.
No deal is off the table. I think it's required in law to send a letter to the other European countries asking for an extension. Now, he said immediately afterwards he wouldn't negotiate an extension. That doesn't mean you won't send the letter. What it means is you send the letter, then you don't ask it. It's rather like your family saying you've got to order, you organise a party for Auntie Bar. You ring Auntie Bar and say, I'm going to organise a party, and you never quite get around to it. Straight on party time in Parliament, fact he has no majority in the House of Commons or the House of Lords to get his Brexit plan, if it isn't rejected, to get it through by the end of October.
Painting a festival. Play strong. Play strong. Play strong. Play strong.
Extra layers built into the scrutiny, which means that this isn't something that can be done in a few weeks at all, and because it is by definition a highly complex piece or package of legislation anyway, why are they even suggesting that it's realistic in our timescale? Now, what would you say to viewers about the timescale and what the government might be able to achieve, given, as Kevin says, that they are very, very hampered in terms of parliamentary numbers?
I think the numbers have changed from when Theresa May was trying to get her deal through. And I think there was a point in the last couple of days when the government genuinely thought, before the Letwin Amendment came along, that they might be going to win this vote today. But we have to think that passing a piece of legislation is not just one off meaningful vote. You don't just have to have a majority for that vote. When you pass Lisbon, when you pass Maastricht treaties, which were similar, complicated things about our relationship with the EU, there were between 80 and over 100 votes on those things. You have to sustain your majority throughout that whole process. Doing that would really work hard.
No!
Well,
down that way when he's not back for another way. He's bullish about it, because it with good humour. But there isn't a master plan, so you say we can do it. But if you're the opposite mind over there, you'll be thinking, well,
this was is 8 November. And
what will be the effect on the economy of this?
The wondering why aren't set.
It would delay it several days for a start. They will come in trying to attach, let's pass this plan, but then put it to another referendum, a fresh vote, a people's vote.
These clothes, that is really bad. Everything's like other clothes.
The numbers who will be queuing up to speak where they all think they're experts.
This is one of the longest times. And things started to improve.
The list actually of former cabinet ministers who voted for the amendments. And they included David Cameron. I know people will say, well, hang on, this isn't that surprising given the line that they've taken. But it's interesting, Amber Rudd, you know, who was
then it went
Justin Greening and Greg Clark. Now, will they just be surprises for the no surprises or surprises for them? But what is the impact of having people of that stature?
I think it's a huge surprise because for a lot of them, their priority has been to stop
their
notice. They can do whatever it takes to ensure that that is still the case. But it is worth looking at who actually put their names to the amendment, because they're split in terms of their overall objection. For that first part of the former Tories, it was an insurance policy against a no deal. But the reason why the government is so nervous and why this is so problematic is that for others, Joe Swinson, the Welsh parties, their objective here was to delay it so that there was an opportunity to table amendments calling for a second referendum.
That's it for today. I'm afraid I can't believe this happened. So I get to the end. So sorry. Please make sure to like and subscribe. Don't miss out on any other new videos.